I welcome you to this lesson once again. I'm teacher Katimbo Richard, teaching mathematics in this class, primary 6. We are looking at forming and solving equations in algebra as a topic. And when you watch this lesson, you'll be able to answer the activities from for the two pages, that is page 116 and 117 of our book, third term or term 3 of P6. Ensure you follow so that you can do the needful. Now, follow these examples, then you will aid answering other activities on those two pages of 116 and 117 of our book. And example number 1 reads, Drusilla is 6 years younger than David. If their total age is 50 years, how old is Drusilla? To this again, Drusilla is 6 years younger than David. If their total age is 50 years, how old is Drusilla? Now, when you see or look at this question, it contains words and you can actually tell it is algebraic. But where does algebra come from when you don't know any party's age here? So we don't know Drusilla's age and neither do we have the knowledge of David's. And if that is so, algebra comes in case person or a learner's person to help that situation. So the fact being that Drusilla is 6 years younger than David, then David is 6 years older than Drusilla. Now they're asking for Drusilla's age, so you say let Drusilla's age be a letter. I chose M, such that when Drusilla is M years old, then David being older by 6 years is M plus 6, because we said if Drusilla is 6 years younger than David, then David is 6 years older than Drusilla. Drusilla who is M years old, then David is M plus 6, is older by 6 years. Now, if their total age, you see the word total here, so that word total is respected by plus sign of addition. So, form the equation here in terms of M through addition, that is M plus 6 equals their total age 50. So this is the statement you have here, thereby forming the equation of algebra. Now we are going to solve it. So M plus M is 2M, then plus 6 is equal to 50. Then work out 2M plus 6 minus 6 is equal to 50 minus 6, indeed. 6 minus 6 is 0, so this side we have 2M and 50. Minus 6, you get 44. So 2m equals 44. And now divide that side by 2. 2m divided by 2 equals 44. Divide by 2. You divide properly 44 by 2 and get m equals 22. Now, the question is how old is Drusilla? Drusilla, the formation here is m years, and which m as well as 22. Therefore, Drusilla's age is 22 years. So, Drusilla is 22 years old. Then part B says, how old is David? Here, the formation against David wrote M plus 6. So write David is M plus 6 years, which M is 22, substitute M with 22. That's 22 plus 6 years, thereby getting 28. So as Drusilla is 22 years, David is 28 years old. So, if you want to check, add these two, 22 and 28, to see whether the total is actually 50. Is it true that 22 plus 28 is 50? Yes, therefore, we justify our answers, and therefore, no one lied to you, failed any. They are actions, therefore. And that's how we answer such a question. And now, number 2. It's almost the same as the other one, only that it's not dealing with age. Look at this. trees. Jesse had 7 more books than Raphael. If they all had, or if both had 35 books altogether, or in total, find the number of books Jesse had. Again, here you need to understand, Jesse had 7 more books than Raphael. Okay. Now that means Raphael had 7 less books or fewer books than Jesse. Now, who has got a fewer? That is, Raphael has 7 less books than Jesse. Now, they're asking for Jesse's number of books. You say, let the number of books Jesse had be a letter K, such that when Jesse has K books, then Raphael has got fewer books than Jesse by 7. So you get that K Jesse had, take away 7. So that is K minus 7 books. So if Jesse has got more books by 7 has got K, then the one has got less, Raphael, by 7 has got K minus 7 books. And in total, meaning they had a total of 35 books. When they combine the books together and count at once, you get 35. So combine, meaning add, that's K plus K minus 7 equals 35. It's the statement here. So that's what's called formation of algebraic equations, or of equations of algebra. So it is formed now. We are then embarking on a journey of solving this equation. K plus K equal to K minus now 7 equals 35. You say 2K minus 7 plus 7 is equal to 35 plus that 7. And now, where 35 plus 7, you get 42 here. So 2K equals 42. And now, let's have to divide both sides by 2. So we go. So actually, this statement goes the other side. We go. Now that we've got 2K minus 7 plus 7 is equal to 35 plus 7, you must note that negative 7 plus 7, or minus 7 plus 7, the same as plus 7 minus 7. So that's why we interchange it for you to understand better. That's 2K plus 7 minus 7 is equal to 42, where 7 minus 7 is a 0, means 2K equals 42. Now we divide either side by 2. 2K divided by 2 is equal to 42 divided by 2. So divide 2 by 2. And 42 by 2 get 21. So the K value is 21. Now, what's the question? Find the number of books Jesse had. Go to Jesse. Jesse had K books. And therefore, Jesse had 21 books because the K value is 21. And now, part B says find the number of books Raphael had. So in the formation here, Raphael had K minus 7 books. So right here, which K is 21. Now 21 minus 7, you get 14. So that is 14 books. As Jesse had 21 books, Raphael had 14 books. You try to see whether when you add 21 and 14, you get 35. And indeed, you get 35. You add. I've added mine, 21 plus 14. Good, 35. So both of them had a total of 35, like it is here. And therefore, no one will lie to you. You failed that. And you see, yes, you had 7 more books compared to this Raphael. Still, it rhymes with the statements brought. And therefore, you must never fear numbers containing words, the one calls. So, you know, I call word problems. These are word numbers, not problems. These are not problems, and which when done, you will not fail. So go to example number 3. So already formed equation for us to open the brackets and do solve thereafter. So for x, given that 3 into 3x minus 1 minus 6 into x minus 2 equals 24. Now you must note that this practice will live only if you multiply the content or their content with whatever is outside. So we multiply 3 by 3x minus 1 and multiply this negative 6 by each of these 2x minus 2. And so doing, you will have opened the brackets. Some people say remove the brackets. I will say you open the brackets, not removing them. Don't get a rubber and erase here. Yeah, so please open the brackets legally, not illegally. Do multiply. And now, before you again multiply, you must consider which integer is opening the brackets. Like 3 is here, is a positive integer. Like 6 here is a negative integer. Now, so negative 6, that is, if the one outside the brackets is a positive one, the signs inside the brackets, that is positives or negatives, remain the same, they remain constant. And if it's a negative, the signs inside the brackets must all be changed. We change them on opening of the brackets. For a positive times another integer, you get that answer, that integer. That means you have a change. And a negative times any other integer, the integer changes. So a positive outside the brackets does not change any sign inside the brackets. And a negative outside the brackets changes all signs inside the brackets. Now we start. We say 3 times 3x, you get 9x. It remains a positive. Then 3 times negative 1 is a negative 3. So it remains a negative. And now we've got 9x minus 3. Now negative 6 times x, you get negative 6x. Negative 6 times positive x, you get a negative 6x. So this x has been a positive. Now they are in negatives. And now negative 6 times negative 2, you get a positive 12. Negative the positive, sorry, negative, you get a positive. Negative the negative, you get a positive. So negative 6 times a negative 2, you get a positive 12, which is equal to 24. So the bracket free equation is 9x minus 3 minus 6x plus 12 equals 24. Now from there, you don't allow change the sign, but only collect the like terms. That is those with x and the 9x. We are now collecting them. No sign changes again, remember. 9x, take away, minus 6x. Now, plus 12, minus 3. That's the statement you have here. 9x minus 6x plus 12, minus 3. Where 9x minus 6x, you get 3x. Then 12 minus 3 equals 9. So the simplifying equation is 3x plus 9 is equal to 24. And now we solve and say 3x plus 9 minus 9 is equal to 24 minus 9. And now 9 minus 9 is a 0. So this side of both 3x and 24 minus 9, you get 15. So 3x is equal to 15. And now divide that side by 3. That 3x divided by 3 is equal to 15 divided by 3. And cancel 15 by 3. Get 5, so x value is 5. And no one will lie to you that that is wrong if you did follow properly. That is x value, so x is 5. And now, number 4, example number 4 says find the value of k, given that 6 into k plus 1 minus into k minus 2 is equal to 13. So here, as 6 is opening the brackets, the sign plus here, remain a plus. And here, a negative here is opening these brackets. Therefore, this will turn to a plus. Now, start. 6 times k is 6k. 6 times 1 is a 6. That's 6k plus 6. Negative times a positive k, you get a negative k. Then negative times negative 2, you get a positive 2, which is equal to 13. So, the statement without brackets is, the equation without brackets is 6k plus 6. I say 6k plus 6 minus k plus 2 is equal to 13. Collect like terms. 6k minus k plus 6 plus 2 is equal to 13. 6k minus a single k, you get 5k. So 6 plus 2 is 8, so 5k plus 8 is equal to 13, then solve that like we did before. That is 5k plus 8 minus 8 is equal to 13 minus 8. And here it's a 0, meaning 5k. And 13 minus 8 you get a 5, so that you have got to divide the other side by 5, 5k divided by 5, because 5 divided by 5, where 5 divided by 5 is a 1, so k equals a 1. And that makes the answer for the value of k in that regard. As we go and look at example number 5, again solving the equations, just emphatic onto the same idea, which idea must be internalized in order for you to solve different equations of algebra. So the opener here is a positive, this remains a minus, and this is a negative, this will turn to a plus. Like you see here, 4 times 3p is 12p, 4 times negative 2, you get negative 8, then negative 5 times p is negative 5p, negative 5 times negative 3, you get a positive 15, which is equal to that 28. So, without practice now, the equation 3 is 12p minus 8 minus 5p plus 15 equals 28. And now gather the p's and non-p's. That's 12p minus 5p as it is, then plus 15 minus 8 here equals 28. Where 12p minus 5p, you get 7p, and 15 minus 8, you get 7. So I've got 7p plus 7 is equal to 28. Then solve as usual. That's 7p plus 7 minus 7 equals 28 minus 7. Here, 7 minus 7 is 0. So this side you have that 7p and 28 minus 7 get 21. So 7p is equal to 21. Then you say 7p divided by 7 is equal to 21 divided by 7. And where p is a 3. And that makes the answer for that particular equation. As we look at example number 6, again, it is bringing the same idea of opening the brackets to work out for the value of k. Find out k in 7 into 3k plus 2 minus 5 into 2 minus 3k is equal to 76. Work out for the value of k. So the opener is a positive, that is, no sign will change, this will remain a plus. And the opener is a negative, this will change to a plus. So we go 7 times 3k get 21k, 7 times positive 3 is positive 14. So I've got 21k plus 14, and this side I've got negative 5 times 2 is negative 10, and negative 5 times negative 3k is positive 15k. So that we've got an equation 3 is 21k plus 14 minus 10 plus 15k equals 76. And now gather the k's and non-k's together, that's what's called collision of like terms. That is 21k plus 15k plus 14 minus 10, the statement here, equals 76. And now 21k plus 15k, you get 36k, where 14 minus 10, you get a 4. So the equation simplified is 36k plus 4 is equal to 76. And now solve as usual again. That is 36k plus 4 minus 4 equals 76 minus 4. And here 4 minus 4 is a 0. So I've got 36k inside. And 76 minus 4 is 72. Thereby having 36k equals 72. So divide that side by 36 to have k alone. That's 36k divided by 36 equals 72. Divide by 36. So by 36 once. By 36 you get k. And now divide accordingly, even 36 itself could divide, but speak. Now let's first divide by 9. 36 divided by 9 is a 4, and 72 divided by 9 is that 8. So I've got 8 divided by 4, by 4 once, by 4 2. So that the value of k is 2, and that's all. All in all, remember how to open the brackets, how to maintain or change the signs. When you are actually opening the brackets, you set a positive integer outside the brackets, does not change any signs inside the brackets, whereas a negative changes all signs inside the brackets. Remember, open the brackets through multiplication of the quantity of brackets by whatever things outside. So that is what's supposed to be done. So the next step is simplifying, is collecting like terms, then simplifying, then later solve to find the equivalent of that unknown involved in a given equation. And which when done, no one will deny you a mark. Finally, we have an example, that is find the value of P in this equation, in this polygon. So look at the polygon given this time. So this is a square. It is a square which you must know that all sides are equal. So this side equal that side, equal that side, equal that side. If so, therefore you get what is here equal to that. You say side equal side, you say 3p plus 3 equals 2p plus 8 as it is here. Then you solve, or you take the 3 other side by subtracting, because the examiner brought a plus. You say 3p plus 3 minus 3 equals 2p plus 8 minus 3. Where 3 minus 3 is a 0, so this side we are left with 3p. So 3p is equal to 2p plus the difference here, 8 minus 3 is a 5. So that's 3p equals 2p plus 5. Now 2p and 3p are like terms, only that each of them is a positive one. So one is 2p. 2p. 2p comes this way because they are scattered. So when it crosses the equal sign, it becomes the opposite of what it is here. So it is a positive, it becomes a negative. So subtract 2p from both sides, that's 3p minus 2p equals 2p minus 2p plus 5, where 3p minus 2p you get a single p, and you're not allowed to write 1 against a letter in algebra. So therefore we say this is the p equals 2p minus 2p is a 0, and then plus 5. So where 0 plus 5 is a 5, so p is equal to 5, and then no one lied to you that anything around there is wrong, and that is what you're supposed to do. And so doing, you'll be able to answer the activities on the two pages of 116 and 117 of our book, Term 3, Primary 6 It Is. Ensure you do the needful. I am Teacher Katimbo Richard. For more information about the mathematics in general or this work in particular, please don't hesitate to reach me on these two numbers, MTN line 0776251655. Alternatively, use the Airtel line 0757233066. I remain this very your teacher, Katimbo Richard. Please remember, COVID-19 is real. Maintain the social distance and all other SOPs. Bye bye.